Supply and demand functions. Our goal, given the supply and demand functions, find the point of equilibrium. Supply and demand curves play a fundamental role in economics. The supply curve indicates how many producers will supply the product at a particular price. The demand curve indicates how many consumers will buy the product at a given price. The equilibrium point is the point and quantity for which suppliers are willing to supply and consumers are willing to buy. It is the intersection of the two functions, supply equal to demand. If you take a look at this graph below, you can see if we look at the supply curve, if the price is too low, suppliers will not supply the item. As price increases, more and more suppliers will produce the item. If you look at the demand curve, if price is too high, very few consumers will purchase the item. But as price begins to decrease, the number of consumers willing to purchase increases. The point we're concerned about is the point where everybody's happy. The suppliers will supply at a given price, and consumers will purchase at a given price. Find the equilibrium point for the demand and supply functions for the ultrafine coffee maker, where Q represents the number of coffee makers produced in hundreds, and X is the price in dollars. So we want to find where the demand curve is equal to the supply curve. Now there are two ways of doing this. We can do it algebraically or graphically. We will do it both. Well, if we want to know when these two functions are equal to each other, we can simply set 50 minus 1/4 x equal to x minus 25. This is our demand function. This is our supply function. Let's solve for x. Now, the first thing I notice here is we have a fraction involved. I'm going to clear the fraction by multiplying both sides of the equation by 4. That would give us 200 minus x is equal to 4x minus 100. Solving for x, let's add x to both sides. That would give us 200 is equal to 5x minus 100. Add 100 to both sides. 5x equal to 300, divide by 5, x is equal to 60. 60 is the price of the equilibrium point. That's how much the item should sell for. Now, remember, the equilibrium point consists of the price and the quantity. In order to find the quantity, we have to set x equal to 60 in one of these functions. Let's go ahead and use the supply function. So the number of items, or the quantity, is equal to 35, but remember from the original problem, this was in hundreds. So to get the true quantity, we have to multiply this by 100 to get 3,500. So the equilibrium point is when the price is set at $60 and the quantity produced is 3,500. Our textbook likes to use this notation, x sub e, Q sub e, as the point of equilibrium. So in this case, we would have $60 as the price and 3,500 for the quantity. I do want to point out this is the opposite order of the initial example that we showed on the first screen. The quantity was the x coordinate and the price was the y coordinate. It doesn't matter which order these are in as long as we're consistent. Let's take a look at this same problem graphically. I've already graphed the demand function in blue and the supply function in red. This would be, graphically, this would be the equilibrium point, and it does verify our answer. Looks like the price would be $60 and the quantity on the y-axis would be 35, but of course this is quantity in the hundreds. So it does verify a price of $60 and a quantity of 3,500 coffee makers. I hope that helps explain and review how to find the equilibrium point given the supply and demand functions. Thank you.